What is good mga champion and welcome back to another video. For today's video guys, since marami sa inyo nagre-request ng sir, scalping naman dyan. Okay, for today's video, I will show you the process on how we do scalping using just the basic TFP wire system. Again, I do have a lot of videos pertaining to scalping, but nevertheless, I will show you how I look for opportunities using top-down analysis. We must ensure that we always utilize multi-time frame analysis to have a bigger perspective when it comes to finding opportunities, right? So the purpose lang naman ng scalping is to simply capitalize from the market from that small fluctuations of the price. Nevertheless, we can have multiple trades in just a short period of time provided that we are trading within the day, alright? But before that, thank you so much to all my TFP VIP champion students all over the globe, subscribers, followers, and to all my supporters, right? So without further ado, let's get straight to our charts. All right, so what do we have here? So when we talk about scalping, our mindset is simply trading short term. Ibig sabihin yan, we want to look for opportunities within the day, okay? May it be 1 hour, 4 hours, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, as long as you have that confirmation for opportunity. And for that execution, then we can take the trade from that small fluctuations. So, since scalping, the normal process that I do is simply knowing where am I at the bigger picture. So, kung makikita natin dito, structure-wise, iba, meron tayong uptrend as the initial group. Okay? Tandaan nyo, even though nag-scalp ako, I want to make sure na aware pa rin ako nasan ako sa higher time frame. That gives me the overall picture. So, hindi ako magugulat if possible na tumaas o bumaba yung market out of nowhere because I know that there are some key levels more than the range na tinetrade ko, alright? From that short-term perspective. So, alright. So, meron tayong group ng uptrend dito initially from this part. So, aware tayo that the initial move ng market is uptrend. There's momentum ng buyers. Nevertheless, after that, nagkaroon ng pause. Okay, nagkaroon ng consolidation, which means the market now is on an indecisive stage wherein there are equal buyers and sellers from this weakening of momentum, di ba? Imbes na magkaroon siya ng higher high, nagkaroon siya ng lower high. So, ibig sabihin, the market settled from these equal highs and lows. So, anong relevance niya sa scalping? So, ibig sabihin, on a bigger scale, on a bigger perspective, aware ako that I am now sitting on a bigger, what? Consolidation. So, we just plot our simple support and resistance as a whole pertaining to our daily perspective. So, yan yung ating daily perspective ng market perspective. Okay? So, ngayon, how will I know if I will have opportunity from short term? Okay? Diyan magmamatter yung inyong previous day candle. Bakit? Tandaan nyo, we want to make sure we want to capitalize on this short-term move. So, ibig sabihin, merong relevance yung previous day candle. Bakit? That would provide us structure na would make us some clues and of course, show us opportunity from that prior structure. So, I will mark my daily high, previous daily high, which is itong malaking bearish candle na to. Okay? So, aware tayo that we have resistance dito, di ba? We have the resistance level coming from the daily perspective. But take note, we are now looking specifically saan? We are now looking specifically sa previous day. Kaya ito yung range natin na gagalawan. Ibig sabihin, I have a lot of space to look for opportunity. Maraming pwedeng gawin yung market, pataas man o ano, pababa. So again, we have here the daily high. Previous day high yan, okay? Previous daily high, previous day low, okay? So, over tayo dyan, okay? So, liitan ko na lang para ito yung ating right? So, next, since wala ka nang makitang clues, di ba nga, short term tayo, so that's the time we have to go down sa mas mababang time frame. So, that's the time I will look for opportunities lower than daily, which is, for example, 4 hours. I may look for day trading opportunity Then as we scale that, we look for scalping opportunity. So I will go down to 4 hours. Okay, the usual process na ginagawa ko from my past videos, but then again, it is giving you ideas para alam nyo kung ano yung gusto nyong opportunity. Okay, so ngayon, makikita nyo, we have 4-hour candles here. So, ibig sabihin yan, anong magmamatter dyan? Do we see any significant structure? Okay, so since scalping tayo, we want to make sure makakuha tayo ng opportunities within that 4-hour candle. Okay, so of course, same na ginawa natin sa higher time frame, like daily, previous daily high and low, ganun din yung gagawin natin sa 4 hours. Then as we scale down to the lower time frame, yung mas mababa sa 4 hours, then magkakaroon tayo ng mas malaking overall idea dun sa structure niya as a whole, dun sa ating lower time frame. So kasi ngayon, medyo vague pa yung itong market, di ba? Parang wala akong makitang significance as of now, but again, what I want is an opportunity within this 4-hour candles. So, ano gagawin ko? I will mark my 4-hour previous high, which is ito, di ba? And 4-hour previous low. Ito. So, around this level. So, take note, this is our 4 hours previous high. And ito yung ating 4 hours previous low. Okay? So, around this level. Okay? So, ngayon, ano nakikita nyo, di ba? Yung ating previous 4-hour candlestick is na-dominate ng ano, ng sellers. Bakit? Makita nyo, yung previous low was broken given this current 4-hour candle. So, anong gagawin ko? I want to look a structure if it would make sense na masasatisfy yung mga system rules. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, I want to know what's happening inside this ano, 4-hour. Yun yung purpose ng ano? Yun yung purpose ng scalping. You want to look into small details dun sa mas mababang time frame provided you are guided nasaan kasaan sa mas mataas na time frame sa'yo. Yun yung relevance why we use multi-time frame analysis. Okay? So, as I go down sa mas mababang time frame, let's say 1 hour, which is the usual sequence. Okay? Ano makikita natin? Ngayon, medyo nagkaroon na siya ng structure, di ba? So, can I plot my other confluences? Di ba? So, ano yung mga major confluences na pwede kong tingnan dyan? Okay? Of course, trend line. So, usually, pag gumagamit tayo ng trend line, at least meron tayong 2 points to connect. Okay? From one point to the other. So, saan nanggaling yung point? Itong previous daily low and yung aking point na to. Kasi kung babasahin structure, di ba? Market, from this point of view, nagkaroon siya ng ano? The market went up from this strong impulsive move and then went down. So, ibig sabihin yan, bumaba man siya, is still a higher low compared to the previous low. So, which means, we really cannot say na ang market is bababa or tataas provided magkaroon siya ng panibagong higher high. Nevertheless, ano ginawa ng market? Nagkaroon ng ano? Lower high. So, which means, currently, market is indecisive whether it's going up or going down. So, merong buyers and sellers at this point on an equal level. Kaya siya nagkaroon ng semi-consolidation. Even though meron tayong higher low, magkaroon naman tayong lower high. So, ipit yung price at this level. So, anong gagawin ko? So, meron tayong confluence. We have this trend line support. How about trend line resistance? Can it be a confluence sa mas mababang time frame as we go down para magkaroon ng clues whether we're going to buy or sell? Maybe we can connect that point since meron naman tayong 2 points na from this point of view and this perspective. Okay, so meron tayong point dito na trend line resistance. Okay, since in consolidation market, what we want is to simply, how are we going to look for opportunities? Okay? So ngayon, kung nakikita natin, meron akong break of previous 4-hour low. Diba? Makita nyo, yung kaninang candle na one candlestick na 4 hours have been broken down into series of hourly candles. So ngayon, kung makita natin, yung previous 4-hour low is nabasag nitong strong impulsive move na bearish candle. So, at this point, do I have any clue? So, ang alam ko lang is, in terms of confluence, I have broken this what previous trend line support, this 4-hour candle low. So ibig sabihin niyan, my bias now is simply downtrend. Otherwise, I may need to check sa mas mababang time frame prior in execution. So this is the time. So kung makikita natin, di ba? If I were to look for HPT zone, di ba? Ang HPT zone ko would be here as a sell, since ang bias ko ay sell. Bakit? Bakit yan HPT zone? Tandaan nyo, as a seller, you must be below trend lines, broken trend line support. Okay? You must be below horizontal support that apparently have been broken. So in future, it would become a resistance. So ito yun. And of course, as a confluence, additional confluence, you must be below trend line resistance, which apparently nandito yan. So ito talaga yung tinutumbok na ano clues na pinoprovide sa akin ng market. Hindi ko pinilit yan. We don't guess this, but the market is showing us where to trade, where is the high probability trade zone as a short opportunity. Okay? So dito yung ating HPT zone as a selling. So anong gagawin ko? I will go down sa mas mababang time frame to look for execution, whether it will satisfy again our system rules. So, baba na tayo ng 5 minutes. Okay? So, the point here is, yan. Market now is nandito sa aking HPT zone sell. Bakit? Sabi ko nga, as confluence, ang bias ko na is naging selling dahil it satisfies system rules such as broken trendline support. I am now below prior horizontal support and ako ngayon ay nasa ilalim naman ng trend line resistance. So ito yung aking tinutumbok. So what I want to see is a selling pressure candles settling dito sa aking ano, dito sa aking what HPT zone na sell as a selling area. Bakit? Ang tandaan natin, we want to look for momentum ng sellers dito sa aking HPT, provided na ang market now has this impulsive move. So kung isusum ko yung market currently, so kita naman natin na meron pang presence ng buyers. So mas maganda ganito ang gawin ng price. Okay? Magkaroon siya ng structure na lower high and then higher high. And then dun sa higher high, magkaroon siya ng shooting star or engulfing kung ano man. In that way, I can still use confluences following entry confluences, yung ating, di ba, break of what? Break of trend line support. Kasi bakit? In this 5 minutes, pwedeng magkaroon pa yung structure, di ba? So, mas gusto natin na ano, conservative way of trading. Pag nabasag yan, we are now really below major key levels sa mas mataas na time frame, at also, we satisfy the same rules of concepts dito saan? Sa lower time frame. So, what I want to see, okay, so hindi ako impossibly magsasell dahil nasa selling area na siya. No. What I want for the market is magkaroon siya pa ng structure, magkaroon ng lower high, higher high. Okay, ano pa? Mas maganda magkaroon niya ng double tops or triple tops. Okay, at ano pang pwedeng gawin ng market? Magkaroon ng, sabi ko nga, ng tinatawag nating shooting star. So in that way, kapag nagkaroon ng structure dito, I can break this level. Okay, saan ako papasok? Pag nabasag to, okay, use this support, na dating support, is nabasag yung maging resistance, same process. I will sell at this area, place my ano, sell limit or instant execution, di ba? And then, place my target as 1:3, or if gusto nyo, tignan nyo yung structure sa ilalim, since meron tayong previous 4-hour ano or hourly candle previous low, yun yung gawin nyo. Okay, as main target. So that would provide you 1:3.5 to 1:4 opportunity. So again, we have to wait for the timing. Hindi porket scalper tayo, is simply impulsively magte-trade tayo ng mabilisan. We still have to follow system rules. Yun yung purpose ng system. Again, goal natin as a trader is hindi ipilit yung trade. Hindi susunod sa atin ang market. Okay? We only trade based on satisfying our system rules. Yun yung purpose ng system. Sabi ko nga, pwedeng yung sistema mo ay iba sa akin. So, pwedeng wala akong trade ngayon. Pero kayo, based sa system nyo, pwede na kayo mag-trade. So, Sabi nga, it doesn't justify na mali ako o tama ka. Ang point ko doon, magkaiba tayong system, rules. Okay? If it satisfies my system, then magka-trade ako. If it doesn't, I will have to wait para mag-materialize yung trade ko on a winning high probability trade. Alright? So I hope you get this idea how I plot, how I use multi-time frame analysis in order for me to look for opportunities. Imagine ninyo, coming from daily, 4 hours, 1 hour, and 5 minutes, that provide me the overall perspective, nasan ako sa bigger picture, going down. And that will solidify yung inyong analysis technically. Okay? Plus, magiging solid pa yan if you have fundamentals to add up your technical analysis. So, ngayon, since nasa short term ka, that's the time you will check nasa ang session kayo at nasaan yung mga high impact news na pwedeng ma-affect dito sa movement ng price. Right? So, this is just a short video. So, naka-live naman to. So, ang importante dito is giving you ideas na trading should be like a mechanical system. Ibig sabihin, it is a step-by-step process, a sequence in a sense, di ba? So, hindi tayo pwedeng magkaroon ng system na pagdating sa entry, bahala na. Okay? Marami kasi akong na-encounter na people na they say they have strategy, they have system. Pero when I ask, what are your rules? Paano mo masabing dyan ka mag-enter? Paano mo masabing dyan ka mag-exit? They just impulsively say na, no, basta nakakita ko nyan, I will just click instant execution, then sell or buy. So, that doesn't justify na may system ka. No, you have to have system rules. You have to satisfy system rules, right? So, this is just a short video informing you na ito yung process ko, what I do, okay, using TFP wire. This is just basic approach, alright? Take note, okay, I do have TFP VIP champion system, which tinuturo ko naman sa mga mas advanced. But nevertheless, even zero knowledge can cope up with that system. So, doon na, mas malalim nyo pang maintindihan yun. So, if you want to be a student of mine, you may want to check out all the details at the description below for the TFP VIP Champion Mentorship Program. Right? I hope may natutunan naman kayo. Right? So, again, thank you so much to all my TFP VIP Champion students all over the globe, subscribers, followers, and sa lahat ng mga sumusuporta. Right? So, God bless. See you all on the next videos. Bye-bye.
So, I just want to inform and announce that our TFP VIP Champion Student Private Discord Community is already up. And yeah, here we have several channels wherein we share our technical trading ideas among each other. And of course, we also have our weekly trade ideas para sa ating mga weekly forecast para sa mga currency pairs. And some announcement section. And of course, since tayo ay global, of course, we have other students as well na galing sa mga ibang bansa overseas. So, we here we introduce ourselves and introduce kung saan tayo galing, sa bansa tayo ngayon, OFW man o hindi. But nevertheless, this is a healthy community para mag-share ng mga trading ideas para sa inyo guys. And hopefully, I will be putting up a server publicly para sa mga baguhan naman and those mga followers and subscribers natin. Alright? So, yeah, this is just a minor announcement and hopefully, guys, you can join us and make this community grow, lalo na sa ating mga estudyante nag-aaral. Alright, guys? So, mga baguhan pa lang. But nevertheless, everyone here wants to learn, wants to make profit from the market. But as much as possible, we're all equal in the eyes of the market. Alright, guys? So, that would be it. So, yun lang. And thank you very much. Alright, bye-bye.